This just in, the bigots in the National Organization of Marriage have just mobilized in the state of Maine. Here's Prag Talk to give you the more info. Hello, my subscribers, fellow YouTubers, and fellow Americans. Today is a sad day, because the same people who did Prop 8 in California have now decided to invade the state of Maine. And, you know, they've got a real jump start on their plans on what they're doing. Because I just read that right here in front of me. It says, as opponents of marriage equality in Maine collect signatures to repeal the marriage bill recently passed by the legislator and signed by the governor, news today from Portland Press Herald signals they're serious about mounting a large-scale campaign. The anti-gay side has hired Frank Schubert, whose firm led California's Yes on 8 campaign, and we all know how that turned out. One of the keys to their victory was attacking huge donations through organized religious groups outside of the state, most notably the Mormon Church. I'll also note that the National Organization for Marriage of the Gathering Storm ad, still no storm, has already given the campaign at least $60,000. They have $60,000 already, and you can bet your bottom dollar they're going to be getting a whole lot of more money from organized religious groups, like they said, such as the Mormon Church. Now, some things I would like to point out, though, is the fact that they get mad at us, the LGBT community, when we protest in places like California, where there is Prop 8, and they tell us, respect the legislative process, respect the voice of the people, respect the votes, respect this, respect that. But, and we protest and they get angry. But now look what's happened in Maine. The state of Maine went through the legislative process and was signed by the governor. And what are these people doing? They're signing petitions, they're protesting, and they're angry over the fact. And they're not respecting the legislative process. They tell us, once the legislative process has passed and you guys have lost, just get over it and move on and forget about it. But when they lose, oh no, 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 no. The rule doesn't apply for them. Here, once again, that shows us the double standard and the two-faced bastards that they are. The fact that they're, what they're really trying, let me translate in bigot for you what they really mean that they're saying is you can't do it because we don't like you and you should just get over the fact that you don't have any rights and that makes us happy. But when you win, we have the right because we're the majority and we can do this and we can do whatever we want and we don't have to sit here and lie down and take this and we don't have to learn to respect people and treat people equally and respect people and all this other stuff. That, you know, that's for stupid people, okay? That's what the real translation is. So, until the day comes that they respect the legislative process, I ain't respecting the legislative process. And despite the fact that the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of all the states are there to protect minorities. That's what they're for. I'm so tired of people hearing say, oh, well, the majority voted this, the majority that, blah, blah, blah. Guess what? You're the majority. The laws, there are more laws there to protect minorities than there are majorities. That's the whole point of a democracy. Okay? That's the whole point of a democracy. But, you know, and I'm just sad at all the selfishness that I see. There's so much selfishness and two-faced doubled standards in this whole country, and it's sad. You know, and I don't want to take, you know, I'm not trying to insult anybody, because I know lots of people who are on my side. But I just want to be able to talk for 1 second to my black brothers and sisters, my black fellow Americans, and to the women of this country. Have you forgotten? Have you already forgotten what your ancestors went through? Or maybe some of your ancestors that went through it are still alive today. Go to them and ask them, what does it feel like to be discriminated? What does it feel like to have the fear that you may walk down the street and somebody may want to shoot you, beat you, and kill you? What does it feel like to wake up one morning and find out that a church full of your family and friends was blown to smithereens just because of the people that were in the building, and that some young girls were murdered out of cold blood because of the color of their skin? Have you forgotten the days that you marched and you went down the streets and they pulled out the hoses and they sprayed them at you to shoot you back? Have you forgotten the day that Rosa Parks stood up because she was not going to sit at the back of the bus anymore because she is just as good as everybody else in this country, despite the color of her skin? It doesn't matter the color of your skin. It doesn't matter your sexual orientation. It does not matter who you love. Women, have you forgotten when the men were the oppressors? Have you forgotten when you were not allowed to get jobs? Have you forgotten when you were property owned by your father and then sold to your husbands? Have you people forgotten these things? Now, I know some of you haven't, because I've talked to them, and they're in pain right now because they just can't understand why one group that has suffered through so much discrimination, two groups that suffered through so much discrimination, and as they come out of it, they can still turn around and discriminate against somebody else. They know the pain. They know the suffering that people, and yet they're able to turn back around and discriminate against someone else. You say, oh, well, the Bible says homosexuality is wrong. Well, last time I checked and I look up in the archives, people use scripture verses against black people. People use scripture verses against women. Wake up and smell the roses and join the right side of history and fight against discrimination in this country. It is so prevalent in this country, everywhere. From the tiniest thing about a person, they can be discriminated against, made fun of, and even killed for it. This country is so divided just because of differences, skins, sexual orientations, and religious beliefs or non-religious beliefs. Everybody needs to just get over it. Believe what you want to believe. Go where you want to go. But in the process, don't discriminate, don't hurt, and don't destroy other people's lives. Double standards, selfishness, all through this country. It's a damn shame. Damn shame. I'll leave in the sidebar a way you can get to the Maine marriage organization, and you can donate to them, even if it's just a frickin' dollar. I donated $5. Even if it's just a frickin' dollar, you donate to them, and you help this cause, and you save the rights of these people. Do what you know in your heart is right. Stop the discrimination. It needs to end today, and these people need to stop trying to take our freedoms and rights away from us, because we are Americans too. We fight for this country too. We love this country too. It's sad because so many people nowadays get it wrong when they say love is a tradition. No, love is a gift. It's a beautiful, beautiful gift between two human beings that love each other. And I find it so funny that people try to take something as complicated and something as diverse and random as love and try to control it and say who can love who and when and how and what it's going to be like. It's just ridiculous. But you know, yesterday is history. It's the past, and the past is never coming back. It's already done. So let's forget about the past, and let's start making the future brighter. Stop being on the side of hatred. Stop being on the side of bigotry. And I have girls who are my subscribers, and I have black people who are my subscribers, and I thank you for joining in the fight with me on the right side of history. And I've seen your pain and how sad you are that people of your groups, your fellow friends and neighbors and brothers and sisters, are not on board with this. That's why you're in that home, though. That's why you've been placed there, to show them the light and show them the way, and let them know that discrimination is wrong. No matter who it's towards, discrimination is wrong. So, you all have a nice day, and I hope this message gets to you and touches your heart and opens you up to realize the wrong that is in this country. And to all you National Organization of Marriage people and to Frank Schubert and all those other people, I don't dislike you. I don't hate you. I don't have a problem with you. I feel bad for you and I care for you and I hope that one day your eyes will be open. because I want to be able to be on good terms with everybody. I care about everybody. That's my whole message of this thing. Just because you don't like me doesn't mean I don't care about you. I care about you, and I hope one day that we can all be equal together. And then I can defend you when you need defending. You have a nice day. Every dream